EDSvideo.com. Thank you.
Hello friends, Dr. Carlo Ojed. In this video, there's plenty of abscess videos out there. I've done a couple myself, but this one's very different because the approach to the drainage was different. This patient presented because of trauma to his face. He had a previous cyst and it became really swollen acutely. I actually thought this was a hematoma, that it burst a blood vessel and it bled into it. But because it was causing so much discomfort and pain, I decided to go in and drain it to see what came out, blood or pus from infection. And as you can see in the video, when I started draining, it was really hard to get anything, but finally it came out a little pus. And when I got it out of the syringe, it was really, really smelly. That's when I said, okay, it needs to be drained. This is very big and there's infection in there. And the approach was done from the intraoral route or the mucosa. Why did I do that? It made it more difficult, a lot more difficult, but I didn't create any scars in the face or any damage or trauma to that. So this is why this video is different, and hopefully you learn a different approach to handling this kind of problem. The other thing is, the scar tissue was so hard. It was difficult to penetrate with the blade. You'll see me kind of trying to get in there. It was really hard. And it took me a scissor to do blunt dissection to get to the actual cyst of the abscess and puncture it. And once punctured, I had to open the scissors inside, and that helped me get what looked like really, really hard cottage cheese, very, very smelly. As you go through the procedure, and I'm going to try to list on the bottom so you can go straight to the part where you get the pus out. But if you're here to learn about medicine and how to do this kind of procedure and how it's done in real life, then watch the whole thing, and I hope you learn plenty. And again, thanks to the patient for allowing us to record this so that you all can learn about procedures and about emergency medicine in general. See you soon. Bye-bye. All right. Just for the video, you tell us how it happened again. You've had a cyst for a little while.
Yeah, it's a very small, like, sweet pea size. And then I was asleep, and my wife rolled over and I guess elbowed me or something in the face somehow. Mm-hmm. And instantly I woke up and I was shooting with pain. It was horrible pain. And it just swelled up, like, by the time I grabbed my face, there was a big knot on my face. My vision in my left eye went blurry. The sinuses are getting clogged up in my left side because of the, I guess, the swelling of it contracting my nasal cavity.
So if you didn't give me the history of the trauma, I would have thought this was like a dental abscess and some kind of infection from your tooth going into your maxillary area.
Yeah.
But with the history of the trauma, I'm thinking more of a broken blood vessel and hematoma now. You don't really have to drain them, but because it's causing so much pain and discomfort, then you do drain those just for comfort. Okay. And the second reason we want to do that is because we don't really know.
Yeah.
So if I go in there and drain pus out, then it is infection, even though I thought it wasn't.
And then if that is the case,
if it's just blood, then it's just cold pack and you know, wait it out. If it's pus, then we gotta give you antibiotics and those kinds of things.
Okay.
Let me get you some paper towels in case.
And what is the possibility about it swelling back up and filling back up?
Pretty good, but then it'll have a way to escape, so it shouldn't.
Okay.
Usually, when the blood vessel breaks and it bursts and it bleeds into an area, it tamponades. Eventually, it feels the pressure and stops the bleeding. Right now, all we're trying to do really is to release the pressure that is creating the discomfort and pain.
Okay.
So first thing we're using is just simple lidocaine. I'm going to do a local injection, just like the dentist, to try to numb that area.
Okay.
So you're going to tilt your head this way. Good right there. Right, pinch and a burn. So I injected about 2 cc's of lidocaine. We wait about a minute.
I give you credit. You're much more gentle than the dentist was.
Oh, that's good. Thanks.
Yes.
Okay. So now that the patient is numb with the lidocaine that was injected into the oral mucosa internally, I actually changed syringes to a 10cc syringe with a thicker 18-gauge needle. And I'm using the spot I already numbed to go in to the mucosa. There I'm in. And I'm actually going in further and deeper until I get some stuff out. There it felt like I popped something and I get some stuff out, but what came out was thickened, dark, fluid type stuff. See, right there, you see it coming out. But it wasn't that much. I thought it would just kind of flow into the syringe, especially being so big. So I'm kind of move the needle around and see if it any more will come out. Then I finally give up and dump it into the gauze outside, and it was smelly. It was clearly pus and abscess. That's when I decided, okay, we gotta go in and try to drain this. So here's me just trying to see if anything more comes out, but nothing did. I don't know if they can appreciate. So this is a second attempt to see if, okay, now I got a little bit out. Maybe I'll try a different angle and see if I get a little bit more. So again, I'm aiming right at the lesion, just going underneath in the mucosa. And I did get some more stuff, but again, same thing. It wasn't that much, definitely not for the size of this lesion. We should have got plenty.
It's almost too thick to get it out. It's got quite the
quite the smell there.
Yes, sir. It's right there below my nose.
And this is kind of what came out from the needle. So it's not real. But you were pretty numb when I did that?
Yeah.
So you want me to try to put some more numbing medicine?
You could if you wanted, because I could feel it a little bit.
But when we numb the surface. The actual mass is still painful.
Yeah, I don't feel nothing in the mass. It was just a little.
When I was with the needle?
Just a little.
Well, let's put a little more medicine. Why not?
You're pretty good with that.
Well, thank you. So once we actually cut, there's going to be pus coming out. So we got some towels here so you can spit it out.
Uh-huh.
And then, of course, you can reach over there in the sink and wash out. Once we're done, you'll wash and rinse your mouth. I definitely, you don't want to swallow any of that.
Yes, sir.
It's very uncomfortable. Paper towel here, too. And again, we're just trying to grab that mass from the inside and just approach towards it. All right, this is the fast-forwarded version of this. I'm using a blade to kind of cut the mucosa. And it's really hard because the mucosa moves a lot. I'm trying to use the lesion to fixate and see if I get in there. And I'm really not getting in. Basically, I did cut the mucosa. That's where you get a little bit of blood. But I'm not getting in deep into the space. Now, at first, I'm thinking, okay, if I just stabilize enough, I'll get in there. There's a little bit of bleeding, so I'm cleaning the patient around. And I'm really just trying to get the blade into that abscess, hoping that, boom, this stuff will come out, pus everywhere, and then I'll be done. But frankly, it didn't happen that way. I gave up with the blade and then started doing some blunt dissection with scissors, which you'll see in just a couple minutes. Now I'm using the scissors to do some blunt dissection.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of get into that space.
Yeah, I can breathe out of my left side of my nose now.
Now I'm just kind of massaging it and trying to get as much. Now that cyst, even though we emptied it, it's still there. So I'm gonna try to do a rinse. If you swallow the lidocaine, it's not a big deal. I think I'm done. I mean, we got a lot of stuff out. The problem is this, that cyst is still there. We didn't fix it. We can't take it out. I'm not a maxillofacial surgeon, dentist. What they're going to have to do is kind of remove the nucleus, or else it'll happen again. You know, what you need to do at home is keep using some warm compress, massaging that area, using like half peroxide, half water, and washing off really good, massaging as much as you can out, because now you have a hole. That's good. It'll let that infection come out.
EDSVideo.com. Thank you.